You're watching WFTDA.tv.
My name is Lacey Knight, and I skate with the Angel City Derby Girls. I've been evolving more and more into just having things that I know are going to be reliable, that they're going to last, and that they're going to do exactly what I want them to do. When you've reached a certain place in your derby career, it becomes less about how much you're spending on the equipment as it is about what it's going to do for you. I need to be able to have it conform to my foot so that it's just an extension of who I am as opposed to this thing that is now on my foot. The right L boot that I have now has been able to successfully do everything I need it to do. This year has even gotten better for me, and my skating is the best it's ever been, and it's the best boot that I've ever had.
They say we don't do enough. We don't stock enough skates, especially the bargain basement variety. We don't carry in lines or know the best place to get them. We don't have every package from every manufacturer. They say all these things. Yet every day, we measure your feet. We study your stance and tailor your fit. We mount your plates and answer your questions. We build skates that make you fly. We're not here for them. We're here for you. And we want to make you go really, really fast. Make them catch up. Visit us online at fastgirlskates.com.
My name is John Maddening. I am here with Brad Example. Sorry, there's a mic check going on behind us. Welcome to the Sacramento Memorial Auditorium here in beautiful downtown Sacramento, California, for the first day of the first D1, that's a lot of ones, playoff tournament in the WFTDA 2014 season.
We're looking forward to a great day of roller derby. We have six games on tap for today, and then the winners of those games will be determining who goes into the next 2 days of competition. Our very first game, starting at 10 a.m. Local time, Pacific time.
Pacific time, let's call it.
And then it's going to be Kansas City Roller Warriors, a stalwart and founder of the Women's Flat Track Derby Association, taking on the New Hampshire Roller Derby, who last year had made their first appearance in the playoffs.
Yeah, and we got powerhouses, of course. We have Gotham, we have Minnesota, we have Denver, we have Rad City. But we also have these first early games that I'm really excited about. First off, of course, that Kansas City and New Hampshire game you mentioned. But also, right after that, Blue Ridge takes on Tampa. Never met before. I'm excited to see what happens. It's going to be a fun day. Fun weekend.
Well, and the first game of the day, Kansas City versus New Hampshire. They've only met once. Kansas City took that game, but they are ranked neck and neck. Not only are they the number 8 and number 9 seeds in this tournament, in the WFTDA, they're ranked number 33 and 34. So that tells you it's going to be a really close game.
Pretty close, pretty fun. Now remember, if you're just listening to the audio stream, that's free, of course. But for the entire weekend, you can get the high-quality video for only $12 or $50 for all four playoff tournaments plus championships all together, WFTDA.tv. We're going to go to the national anthems pretty soon of the United States and Canada. And then we'll go up to the broadcast team, which is Joe Mama and, of course, my lovely and talented co-host here, Brad Example.
Looking forward to bringing that game to you. And the rest of the action, we've got the Denver Roller Dolls taking on Santa Cruz later. Gotham will play the winner of this first game. And then Minnesota will play the winner of Blue Ridge versus Tampa, and we'll wrap up with our marquee game of the Rat City Roller Girls from Seattle, Washington, playing Terminal City Roller Derby from Vancouver.
That's right. That's going to be fantastic. A whole great day of roller derby, the first day of an entire great weekend of roller derby, a whole month of great roller derby, right here on WFTDA.tv. We'll see you in just a few.
And we're very happy to be bringing you the first game of the day.
We're going to be seeing the number 8 seed, which is the Kansas City Roller Warriors from Kansas City, Missouri, taking on the number 9 seed, New Hampshire Roller Derby. This is the second time these two teams have met. Kansas City was victorious the first time. We'll see what happens this time.
All right, so this is day one, D1. Very exciting here in Sacramento, California. Let's go through some rosters here. I'm going to go ahead and read New Hampshire Roller Derby, the Skate for Your Die All-Stars. Number 1874, Claude Monet. Number 1967, Rage of Aquarius. Number 1990, Sea and Spots. Number 21, Decker. Number 26, Chica Chica Bam Bam. Number 3333, Chicana Bruzia. Number 36, Boyer. Number 6, Makilla Queen. Number 60, Swerko. Number 828, Kissy Kicks. Number 87, River Song. Number 987, Techno Destructo. Number MI6, Persassin. Number PM5, Game Overies.
And in skating in white for the Kansas City Roller Warriors, got number 0, Peter Babriel. Number 10, Enigma. Number 11 is Barbarian. Number 111, Annie Mall. Number 2012, Evolution. Captain, number 24, Bruiser. Number 25 is Estee Slaughter. At number 26, we have Bella Fire. Number 47 is Dr. Dread. Number 79, Mary Lou Wretched. Number 84 is Tough Noogies. Number 913, Jamalama Ding Dong. Number 99 is Ram Ram. And number D11R is Rump Wrecker. And the very first jammers on the line, number 47, Dr. Dread for Kansas City, taking on number 60, Swerko for New Hampshire.
All right, once again, New Hampshire in the black, Kansas City in the white. We are just about ready to start. They are at the Fast Girl Skate start line, ready to begin.
Remember to stay tuned to WFTDA.tv this weekend, not only for video coverage, but for audio coverage as well if you're not able to be at your computer. And we're gearing up to go.
All right, both jammers attack the walls. Kansas City walling up in the rear. New Hampshire walling up in the front. Dr. Dread now looking for a spot on the inside. Swerko working the edges. Both jammers still stuck around turn one. Nice work on the outside, and Swerko through lead jammer, New Hampshire. Dr. Dread with some nice edge work on the inside line. One to beat up front, that's the pivot. And she is through.
Swerko already on her scoring pass, calls it with 4 3 points.
All right, first blood, New Hampshire.
So that was a pretty quick jam, knocking less than a minute off the period clock. So New Hampshire showing that they are no pushovers here, even if they were unable to defeat Kansas City the first time. Peter Babriel, number 0, taking the star for Kansas City, taking on number 3333, that is Chicana Bruzia.
Chicana Bruzia taking the middle line. Peter Babriel on the inside. Once again, tough wall by Casey at the rear. New Hampshire with a tough wall on the front. Peter Babriel now with one to beat up front. And she is through lead jammer, Kansas City.
So evenly split on the lead call so far.
Chicana Breeze is still stuck in the pack. And now a track-cutting penalty assessed to New Hampshire. Power jam, Kansas City. Once again, Kansas City in the white. New Hampshire in the black with the pink accents.
First Grand Slam of the game goes to Kansas City.
Kansas City with some offense there by number 47. Apologies. Number 24, Bruiser.
Defense has become the name of the game in the Women's Flat Track Derby Association, and we're seeing that on full display here as very powerful blocking at the front of the pack contains Peter Babriel. Long enough, in fact, that Chicana Bruzia is back out of the penalty box without any full passes.
Right, Chicana Bruzia now working on that wall of Kansas City up at the front. Peter Babriel on the New Hampshire wall at the rear. Penalty now assessed to Rage of Aquarius for New Hampshire.
Look at that defense there in turn one. They're just not letting either jammer through.
Nice work by both squads. Excellent recycling by both teams. Now Chicana Bruzia out. 5 points assessed to New Hampshire. And Peter Babriel calls the jam, but not before New Hampshire put one more point on the board. 5 points on that pass for Kansas City.
Already our first official time out of the game. And we're seeing the scoreboard being 6-3 in favor of Kansas City with 26 minutes and 47 seconds on the first period clock. If you are new to roller derby, 30 minutes of play in each period. We get, they're broken down into scoring sessions called jams, which last a maximum of 2 minutes. We got 10-3 now with a corrected scoreboard. 10 for Kansas City, 3 for New Hampshire. Your next set of jammers is number PM5. That is game ovaries for New Hampshire. Number 913 is Jam-a-lam-a-ding-dong for Kansas City.
Full packs for both squads. Kansas City walling up at the rear, New Hampshire walling up in the front. Jam-a-lam-a-ding-dong working hard in the middle, pushing always towards the inside. And now we have a low block penalty. Looks like assessed to a New Hampshire skater. And picking up lead, Jam-a-lam-a-ding-dong, KCR Dub. Heading to the box, number 36, Boyer for New Hampshire. And now the pivot from New Hampshire heading to the box as well. That's number 828, Kissy Kicks. And through, 5 points, Jam-a-lam-a-ding-dong, Kansas City.
So an early quick start for New Hampshire, but Kansas City coming back now with a vengeance.
All right, game over, he's out, and Jam-a-lam-a-ding-dong calls the jam. 4 more points for Kansas City. Picking up some steam here, Kansas City 19, New Hampshire 3, 25 minutes and 40 seconds left in the first period of roller derby action.
Thanks to our sponsor, S1 Helmets. S1 Helmets are rad. Get rad. What?
All right. Lining up to jam for Kansas City is number 79, Mary Lou Wretched, up against number MI6, Persassin, for New Hampshire. 4-2 pack favoring Kansas City. Excellent work by that two wall of New Hampshire skaters. But through, Mary Lou Wretched, lead jammer, Kansas City, picking up an out-of-play penalty or failure return penalty. Skater from New Hampshire.
And in fact, New Hampshire owns the penalty board so far. No Kansas City skaters yet penalized.
That was Rage of Aquarius to the box. 5 points there for Mary Lou Wretched for Kansas City. Persassin still stuck behind Enigma and has to recycle all the way behind turn three. Great recycling work themselves by New Hampshire. Oh, and good edge control there by Persassin. She is through for New Hampshire. Mary Lou Wretched calls the jam. Another 4 points on the board for KC. No points for New Hampshire. Kansas City now 28, New Hampshire 3.
9 points on that jam, and we have a timeout being called by New Hampshire. This team timeout brought to you by Roller Derby Athletics. They can change your game in 30 seconds, too. Find out more at rollerderbyathletics.com.
New Hampshire now taking the time. They've got to regroup. 3 points on the board for them. A string of blocker penalties, leaving their jammers all by the lonesome out there, Brad. So I think, hey, bring it in. Let's calm it down. Let's get back to our game.
It's the, we saw earlier, like I said, New Hampshire getting first blood, but ever since then, the game has been all Kansas City. They've scored these 28 unanswered points since that first jam. Kansas City having the advantage both in ranking and in seeding in the tournament and in history between the two teams. And so you know that New Hampshire would love to show that, yes, we can beat these folks. They're only one slot ahead of us in the WFTDA rankings.
Kansas City does have experience on their side. This is only their second time in a playoff. Kansas City has been in it since the beginning.
Dr. Dredd, number 47, taking the star for Kansas City for the next jam, squaring off against number 60, Swerko. So this is a repeat of the first jam of the game. 24 minutes and 7 seconds on the first period clock.
4-on-4 in the pack. Swerko hits the middle. Dr. Dredd now working the edges. pushed out there by number 26, Chicka Chicka Bam Bam by New Hampshire, and recycled all the way back to the jammer line through lead jammer, Swerko, New Hampshire.
Exactly the kind of momentum change that New Hampshire wants.
Multiplayer block now assessed to Chicka Chicka Bam Bam. And then a penalty assessed to a Kansas City skater, Bella Fire, number 26, forearm.
Both numbers 26 sitting in the box.
Oh, nice recycling work by both squads. Swerko, though, on a scoring pass. Dr. Dredd still not out of the pack. Now Dr. Dredd through, eligible to score for Kansas City. Swerko calls the jam. 3 points on that pass for New Hampshire. Doubles their score to 6. Kansas City 28, New Hampshire 6. 23 minutes and 2 seconds left in this first period.
Remember that you can reach us on Twitter, hashtag talk, the numeral 2, WFTDA, if you have comments, questions, whatever you'd like to
glib remarks.
There's plenty of those.
Shekinah Bruzia, number 33-33 for New Hampshire against Peter Babriel, number 0 for KC. 4-3 pack favoring Kansas City.
So this is a repeat of the second jam of the game. Both teams sticking to a four-jammer rotation so far.
Peter Babriel out. Lead jammer, Kansas City. Shekinah Bruzia recycled and picks up a track cut penalty for New Hampshire. 5 points on the board for Peter Babriel in Kansas City.
History again repeating itself. This happened in the second jam of the game.
Excellent work by KC to pull that track cut. Skaters are getting more and more adept at moving backwards in the pack to pull those track cuts. Peter Babriel now putting points on the board for KC. 2 to beat up front. Now 3 to beat. Nice wall and bridging by the New Hampshire squad. Now a release the Kraken. KC through with some offense, trying to free Peter Babriel. 1 to beat now. And through, 5 points, KC. And picking up a penalty is Annie Mall for KC R-Dub.
Jam is more than halfway over.
Shekinah Bruzia with 1 to beat. She is through. Now can score for New Hampshire. Excellent work by Bella Fire. I have recycling Shekinah Bruzia all the way to the back of turn 3. Peter Babriel putting points on the board. And picks up a track cut penalty for Kansas City. We're going to go the full 2 minutes. There are about 14 seconds left in the jam. Annie Mall now rejoins the fray for Kansas City. Oh, and picking up a back block penalty right at the end there. Number 21 for New Hampshire, Decker.
So 3 final points for Kansas City on the last pass. Takes the score to 41 for the team from Missouri to 6 for the team from New Hampshire. The clock ticking at about 20 minutes. And we're just have a power start for number 60, Swerko. For New Hampshire.
Full pack for KC, just 2 out there for New Hampshire. Chicka Chicka Bam Bam back in the mix, and lead jammer, Swerko, New Hampshire.
Peter Babriel's penalty here, the first jammer penalty for Kansas City, and in fact only the second penalty overall.
Peter Babriel now back on the track, along with number 21, Decker, for New Hampshire. 5 points on the board for Swerko. Oh, we have a star pass to Annie Mall from Peter Babriel. Frees the jammer from Kansas City. Good work there by Kansas City. And Swerko calls the jam. 4 more points there for New Hampshire. That'll take their score to 15. Kansas City, 41. 19 minutes and 6 seconds left in the first period of this first bout. of roller derby action in Sacramento. Day one, D1.
Lining up on the fast girl skate start line, we have number 10, Enigma, with the star for the first time today for Kansas City, squaring off against the second jam of the day for number PM5, Game Overies for New Hampshire.
Both squads have four. Once again, Kansas City in the white, New Hampshire in the black. Enigma pushed out right at turn one, recycled all the way to the rear by Makilla Queen from New Hampshire. No skaters have broken through. We still do not have a lead call. Enigma with one to beat, number 21, Decker. And she's through, lead jammer, Kansas City. Took about 30 seconds off the clock there. Excellent bridge work by Kansas City, containing Game Overies right at turn three.
Bella Fire teamed up with number 11, Barbarian, to hang on to Game Overies at the top of the pack.
Oh, such good footwork by Kansas City. And picking up a track cut now is Enigma, Power Jam, New Hampshire, but she is still not out of the pack. Still not eligible to score for her team. It's the bridge work by KC and the excellent blocking by this pair of Barbarian and Bella Fire.
Bruiser and Evolution extending the domain of the pack, allowing the recycling now of Game Overies before she even completes her initial pass.
And that's got to be rough on Game Overies. She's been working so hard for the last 20 seconds or so on that difficult wall of KC skaters. You can see it take the wind out of her sails. And through and out of the penalty box is Enigma. Good penalty kill by KCR Dub.
New Hampshire trying to establish a three ball at the back of the pack.
All right, picking up a full 4 points, though. Just 4 points is Enigma for Kansas City. And that's 2 minutes on the clock for this jam. Kansas City 45, New Hampshire 15. It lost opportunity for New Hampshire there with that power jam. But such good defense by Kansas City right there.
Thanks to Green Monster Roller Sports, makers of Antic Skates, Gumballs, Reckless Wheels, and more.
Number 913 jam for Kansas City, Jamalama Ding Dong. I think it's number MI6, Persassin, for New Hampshire. Both second, squads with four skaters on the track.
Second jam of the game for each of these jammers.
Persassin up at the front, one to beat. Through lead jammer, New Hampshire. Jamalama Ding Dong stuck behind the wall of black at the rear of the pack. And now freed for Kansas City. Persassin through, calls off the jam. 2 points on that pass for New Hampshire. That'll take our score. Kansas City 45, New Hampshire 17. 15 minutes and 40 seconds left in this first period.
So the flow of the game has really been in Kansas City's favor. Although when you actually check, New Hampshire has gotten lead jammer nearly as many times as Kansas City. But Kansas City has been much more effective at converting those opportunities into points.
Kansas City's defense is on point this morning. Whatever they had this morning, the coffee, the tea, it doesn't matter. They are on point. Swerko jamming for New Hampshire. Mary Lou Wretched jamming for Kansas City. Fall down, go boom between the jammer line and pivot line. No lead jam call as of yet. Mary Lou Wretched through lead jammer, Kansas City. Looks like Evolution picked up a penalty, and we have a penalty on the jammer low block call on Swerko. Power jam, KC. Mary Lou Wretched threw 5 points on the board for Kansas City. 4-3 pack now favoring New Hampshire. Good offense to disrupt the defense by Kansas City, but great push up front by New Hampshire, but threw another 5 points to Kansas City. Evolution now making her way back on the track for Kansas City as Swerko makes her way back on the track for New Hampshire. Kansas City now walling up at the rear of the pack. New Hampshire walling up at the front. Swerko comes down to Kansas City's wall. Mary Lou Richard finding a hole. Now one to beat up front. Swerko still working on that wall of white at the rear of the pack. And now excellent recycling here by both squads. Swerko back to turn one. Mary Lou Richard all the way back to the pivot line.
Just about 10 seconds to go in the jam. Hasn't been called off yet.
Got a penalty now on a New Hampshire blocker. And that's the jam. 5 points there for Kansas City. No points for New Hampshire. That'll take our score to Kansas City 60, New Hampshire 17. 13 minutes and 10 seconds left in this first period.
Total of 15 points on the jam for Kansas City. A major factor in this score differential has been the amount of time spent in the notorious RED penalty box. 10 trips to the box for New Hampshire skaters versus only 4 for Kansas City at this point in the game. Make that 5. I do see an additional one. So that's going to... track time is going to be a big factor. Number 33, Chicana Brusia jamming for New Hampshire against number 47, Dr. Dredd for Kansas City.
All right, both skaters pass the fast girl skate start line. And Chicana Brusia up at turn one, working on Kansas City's wall. Dr. Dredd now squeezing through the middle, trying to find an opening. Chicana Brusia takes the inside. She's through lead jammer, New Hampshire, but Dr. Dredd about 10 feet behind. Now this is where it's important. Kansas City walls up at the rear. New Hampshire in front. Chicana Brusia calls the jam. 3 points for Kansas City. No points for New Hampshire. Definitely a win for KC when they did not have the lead call.
So far we are... Okay, so we're ticking down to the... just past the 12-minute... mark in the game. We've got an official timeout stopping the clock at 11 minutes and 55 seconds. And so in all of those 18 minutes of the game so far, we're only going to be, we've had 12 jams in the game so far. And so that is some pretty long jams. And we've seen several of them that have gone the full 2 minutes already.
We've had a couple of lead jammer calls that went, and then they went to the penalty box. So that's a cause for a lot of those 2 minute jams.
Correction, 11 jams, yes.
11 jams. So what's New Hampshire going to have to do here, Brad, to get back in it? Kansas City pretty much has taken the wind out of their sails in terms of the defense, playing very, very tough. What you've seen, you know, since the inception of KCR Dub, grinding defense.
New Hampshire has had success in getting their jammers through the pack even first. They, as I've mentioned, they have nearly as many lead jammer calls as Kansas City. What this means is that... that New Hampshire isn't doing a good enough job of containing the Kansas City jammers. Thank you to our sponsor, Bont, at Bont.com. A lighter, stronger, faster, fully heat moldable, and customizable carbon fiber boots for your skates, Bont. Clock still stopped at 11 minutes and 55 seconds. We now see that this is an official review. Called by Kansas City, looks like. And we're going to find out the cause of that official review. Stand by. Remember that after this game, the next game is going to be Tampa Bay taking on Blue Ridge.
And it's a black official review. They're asking for a low block penalty on the white jammer. We're going to turn things over to our referee. Call stands as it was on the floor.
Yeah, I've observed that it's rarely effective to ask for a penalty because if the referee had seen it in the first place, it would have been called. We got number 913, Jamalama Ding Dong, kicking the next jammer star for Kansas City Roller Warriors against number MI6, Prisassin, for New Hampshire.
Prisassin now takes the inside tack. She's through lead jammer, New Hampshire. They've got to get some containment on the KC jammer here. Jamalama Ding Dong now recycled behind the pivot line. Great work there by New Hampshire. This is the jam they need. Assassin pushing hard on that KC wall. Nice recycling by New Hampshire. Now two to be up front for Prisassin. And she is through. 5 points on the board for New Hampshire. Excellent containment at the back of the pack. Jamalima Dignon now on the outside through. Eligible to score for Kansas City. Prisassin already putting points on the board for New Hampshire. Calls the jam before she beats Bella Fire. So 3 points assessed to Prisassin. Good jam for New Hampshire.
Total of 8 on the jam, taking us down to the 10.5 minute mark in our first period. So 63 for Kansas City, 25 for New Hampshire. And your next pair of jammers, Estee Slaughter, number 25, will jam for the first time today against number 60, Swerko, who started off the day for New Hampshire and has continued to produce good results for them.
Kansas City walling up at the rear, New Hampshire walling up in front. Recycling now, number 1990 C in spots on Estee Slaughter. Quickly reform the wall and through lead jammer Swerko, New Hampshire.
Swerko comes in hot to the pack. Does not pick up a back block, but to the notorious RED penalty box on a track cut is Estee Slaughter for Kansas City, turning this into a power jam, but Swerko calls it with 3 more points. There will be a power start on the next jam. Thanks once again for joining us for the first game of the Sacramento playoffs. We got a whole day of action for you, culminating in the final bout of the game. It's going to be the Rat City Roller Girls taking on Terminal City down from Canada. Do stick around for that.
Two teams within close proximity of each other play each other very often. That should be excellent roller derby. You're going to see excellent roller derby all day here. Right now, Chicana Bruzia jamming by her lonesome for New Hampshire. Right past turn two and picking up lead jammer for New Hampshire.
That's 4 consecutive lead calls for New Hampshire, but they still trail by a bunch of points.
New Hampshire now streaking out their wall, bridging back. So Estee Slaughter has to come back in all the way behind the jammer line. And through 5 more points, Chicana Bruzia, New Hampshire. Estee Slaughter now back in the mix for and looking to pass the star, pulls the jammer cap off and has the star for KC. Right, no, she took it off and she put it back on. A little bit of trickery by KC. Chicana Bruzia, 1 more point on that pass.
Takes us to 34-63. New Hampshire trailing, 8 minutes to go. The trickery availed her not.
Good run here by New Hampshire.
It is actually 5 jams since Kansas City has scored. So this is the kind of comeback, and that all was all based off of that timeout. Well timed. We got number PM5. It's game over ease. Peter Babriel has the star for Kansas City.
And once again, a trend. Lead jammer calls for New Hampshire. PM5, game over, he's through, lead jammer. Peter Babriel now out as well for Kansas City, just about a half lap behind. Peter Babriel making quick work of the track and calls the jam, but picks up 4 points for New Hampshire. Excellent work by game overies. New Hampshire eking their way back into this, Brad.
Yes, it is now 63-38 for New Hampshire as we tick down to 7 minutes to go in our first period. Remember, we've got an entire 30 minutes after halftime thanks to our sponsor, Rollline at roll-line.it. A new generation of roller derby, probably made in Italy. Fine Italian gear.
All right, in the black for New Hampshire, Prisassin.
That was not even close to an Italian accent. You should hit me.
And Mary Lou Wretched jamming for KC. New Hampshire has been, in the last few jams, exceptionally adept at recycling the jammers from KC and picking up lead for Sassin for New Hampshire. The last 6, in fact, have been all New Hampshire for lead calls. Mary Lou Mitch is still not out of the pack. Excellent work by the wall of New Hampshire.
So we're seeing a track cut called on the far side. I think that's number 30. No, it can't be. It is number 36, Boyer for New Hampshire, going to take a seat.
And five more points for Persassin, and still with the relentless recycling of the KC Jammers at that New Hampshire wall. And now picking up a multiplayer block is number 5. There's number 6, McKilla Queen for New Hampshire.
So if you are new to WFTDA Roller Derby, those penalties cost you 30 seconds each in the notorious REV penalty box.
And we have a star pass now to Annie Mall. Successful star pass. And Persassin calls a jam, another 2 points to New Hampshire. Getting within 18 points here. Kansas City 63, New Hampshire 45. 5 minutes and 25 seconds left in this period. I would say the last 6 jams have been all New Hampshire, Brad.
I completely agree, Joe. And this is the kind of comeback that New Hampshire would like. Can they sustain it is the question, and we'll see how the differential is at halftime. Number 47, Dr. Dredd, is the next jammer for the Kansas City Roller Warriors, and number 60, Swerko for New Hampshire, taking us back again to the matchup of the very first jam of the game.
Boyer rejoins the mix for New Hampshire. 4-on-3 pack, still one blocker in the box for New Hampshire, and through lead jammer, Swerko, New Hampshire. They're trending up. That's 7 in a row, Brad.
And showing some fine speed coming back around into the pack before Dr. Dredd is able to get out, which she now does on the outside line.
If there ever was a good timeout called in roller derby, that was it. That really revitalized them. 1 point on that pass for New Hampshire. That'll take the score. Kansas City 63, New Hampshire 46. And now Kansas City calling a timeout of their own to reassess. Again, the last 7 jams, all New Hampshire.
This timeout, sponsored by Roller Derby Athletics. They can change your game in 30 seconds, too. Find out more at rollerderbyathletics.com. And so it seems to me that Kansas City observed the benefits of that timely timeout earlier for New Hampshire and would like to replicate that. The clock is stopped at 4 minutes and 22 seconds. Do remember that you can reach us at Twitter hashtag talk, numeral 2, WFTDA. So this is actually the first rostering time for number 47, Dr. Dredd. You might remember her as Shady O'Dredd in past years. She's been on the All-Star Charter for almost 2 years, but this is the first time she's actually gotten on the track, at least during a tournament, because I think I've seen her skate other bouts this year.
She definitely skated against Denver and Rocky Mountain this past March. So once again, if you want to talk to us on the social medias, hashtag talk the number 2 WFTDA. Want to hear your thoughts, recollections, and sweet observations.
Number 87, River Song, taking the jammer start for the first time of the day for New Hampshire. Back to the jammer line, number 913, Jamalama Ding Dong.
All right, picking up a penalty is Enigma, number 10 for KCR Dub. Jamalama Ding Dong stuck behind the New Hampshire wall.
Kansas City pivot is sent to the notorious REP penalty box. That's Annie Mall.
All right, lead jammer, KC, first time in 8 jams, Jamalama Ding Dong. And now one to beat for Riversong. She is out as well. Jamalama Ding Dong trying to put some points on the board. Back for KC. Calls the jam, but not before New Hampshire puts 3 points on the board. KC only putting 1, keeping that positive point differential for New Hampshire despite not having a lead jam call. Kansas City 64, New Hampshire 49, 3 minutes and 28 seconds left in this first period of roller derby action. Day 1, D1, Sacramento, California.
Thanks for tuning in to WFTDA.tv. If you're listening to the audio-only stream, glad you are with us. We do encourage you to consider upgrading to the video stream. $12 for the weekend or a $50 package for all 4 playoff weekends, plus championships, which will be Halloween weekend in Nashville, Tennessee.
Pictures are pretty.
We're being 5. Game Overies jamming for New Hampshire.
That's Peter Gabriel for Kansas City. Lead jammer, Kansas City. Game Overies stuck behind a wall of white at turn one. Peter Gabriel now putting points on the board for Kansas City. Game Overies out of the box, out of the pack. Now eligible to score 4 points for Peter Gabriel. And she calls the jam before New Hampshire can score. That's the first sets of points. First set of points for KC in 9 jams.
So 68-49 on the board with only a couple minutes left to go. It's conceivable that this jam could be the last jam of the period. More likely, we got a couple to go. Number MI6, Prisassin, will jam against number 10, Enigma. Only Enigma's second time starting off on the jammer line.
First time Enigma jammed, she did go to the penalty box. Prisassin now trying to work the edges and recycled by Bruiser to the back of turn four. Lead jammer, Enigma, Kansas City. Bruiser, stalwart veteran of the Kansas City roller derby scene. Great back and forth work there by Enigma, but equally great wall by New Hampshire. Prisassin still stuck in the pack between turns one and two. And through on the inside, Enigma. That's a full 5 points to Kansas City.
Kansas City now with 3 lead calls in a row and all the points for the last 3 jams so far, trying to recapture that momentum. But this is going to break that with a track-cutting call. In fact, both jammers sent
double track-cut call. Mark your bingo cards. Both jammers to the box. In fact, Enigma called first to the box. But Prisassin made it there first, and Enigma, in fact, overran the box, has to go all the way around, take the long way home, they say. And so she will serve the same amount of time.
But with the now the jam clock controls, so we will, in fact, have this as the last jam of the period. And here's a statistic where New Hampshire doesn't like to be leading. As of this moment, they have twice as many penalty trips as Kansas City, 16 versus 8.
That is no bueno for any team. We're going to go the full 2 minutes here. Enigma standing up in the box. And picking up a back block penalty is Bruiser for KC. And then a penalty assessed to number 21, Decker, for New Hampshire.
The battle continues in turn three.
More whistles. And someone headed to the box as the jam is over. 4 points there for Kansas City. Boyer headed to the box. And that is the end of the first period. The score stands Kansas City 77, New Hampshire 49.
So it started off looking, the first half of this period was pretty much all KC. And then we hit a very long run where New Hampshire got it together and were dominating. And so that is a real advantage for that challenging team. You know, they, like we said at the start of the game, they are the number 34 ranked team in WFTDA. They are the number 9 seed of the tournament. Both of those numbers are one lower than their opponents, Kansas City. And so they would love to take this upset. And it looked like they were on track to do so. Just the last 3 jams of the period is when Kansas City locked it back down.
Forcing the blockers to the box, forcing them to do things that are illegal, really has helped Kansas City. That's where they've been the most successful, is when New Hampshire's only had two or three skaters in the pack. Their jammers have made quick work of those packs. New Hampshire, when they've had all their skaters on the track, have done exceptionally well putting points on the board and having a positive point differential between them and Kansas City. We'll be back in about 13 minutes and 40 seconds. Thank you for tuning in. Day 1, D1, Sacramento, California. WFTDA.tv.
See you soon.
Sometimes when you play roller derby, you're just kind of like, why am I doing this? This is so weird that I essentially have this unpaid second job, which I spend all my first job money to do. And then you go to, you know, you go to playoffs and you go to champs, or you just go to any game and you're like, oh, yeah, this is why I do this. My name's Steph Maney. I skate for the Linden Roller Girls, and S1 is part of my uniform. Oh,
Antic skate boots, you buy some other brand. When you buy some other brand, you suck at practice. When you suck at practice, you're unprepared for Team Antic USA skater Carmen Getsum. When you're unprepared for Carmen Getsum, she destroys you on the track. When she destroys you on the track, you end up on the trainer's table with a concussion and major injuries. Don't end up with a concussion and major injuries. Buy Antic skate boots.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to WFTDA.TV coverage of the first Division I playoff for 2014. We're here in Sacramento, California, at the halftime of the very first game, which is the Kansas City Roller Warriors taking on the New Hampshire Roller Derby. I'm
D1,
Brad Example.
Yeah, I'm Joe Mama. D1, day one, as if we've never called together before, Brad. I'm just going to step all over your feet.
So the story of the first half, if you had not joined us at that point, despite first blood going to New Hampshire, Kansas City then really came back and established up to a 43-point lead over New Hampshire. But then New Hampshire took a very timely timeout, got it back together, and the next eight jams were all New Hampshire.
Correct, yeah. Eight jam, positive point differential for New Hampshire.
Then Kansas City did likewise, took their own timeout, and the last three jams of the game, of the period, were Kansas City, leading to the 77-49-point lead that we have right now. One statistic, every time I've checked where New Hampshire has had a 2-1 advantage over Kansas City is on trips to the notorious REB penalty box, currently standing at 18-9. So that's something that New Hampshire will have to be very careful about in the second half.
Right. They've got three skaters right now with three penalties apiece. Kansas City with only one skater with three and only one skater with two. So Kansas City keeping it very clean out there and keeping their skaters on the track.
So we got about 20 seconds and change before we start our second period. Then, of course, after that, the next game is going to be Tampa Roller Derby taking on, I had it right here.
It's Blue Ridge.
Blue Ridge.
Out of Asheville, North Carolina. Very exciting bout.
And we've got five games total during the day, and we're really looking forward to all of them. Here we go. And Dr. Dredd, number 47, who started off the game for Kansas City, jamming against number 60, Swerko for New Hampshire, also the very first jammer of the game. So will history repeat itself? We shall see. In the very first jam, Dr. Actually, in the first jam, Swirko did get lead and took those first 3 points, but that was the prelude to Kansas City really locking it down for a little while. So let's see how the momentum goes to start off this period.
And they poured it on. 3-2-pack favoring Kansas City. A lot of blockers to the box right at the end of the last jam in the first period. NSO's hands are up. We are about to begin the second half of roller derby action in the beautiful Memorial Auditorium here in Sacramento, California. Kansas City in the white, New Hampshire in the black. Dr. Dre with two to beat up front. Good recycling at the rear of the pack by Kansas City on Swirko. Picking up lead. Dr. Dredd, Kansas City. Swirko now about 40 feet behind and picking up speed.
Signals from the sidelines to the skaters, letting them know what to do.
Picking up 3 points is KC, and also picking up 3 points is Swirko. So 0 point differential there for both squads. Kansas City 80, New Hampshire 52.
That was a quick jam, only about 30 seconds off the period clock, so we'll have 29 minutes on the period clock when we start this next jam that puts Peter Babriel on the line, number 0 for Kansas City, against number 33, Chicana Brusia for New Hampshire on the Fast Girl State's start line.
4-3 pack favoring Kansas City, one blocker standing in the box for New Hampshire. Peter Babriel looking at the inside, and she is through with her toe stops. Lead jammer, Peter Babriel, excellent work there. Use those grippy toe stops to stay in bounds and pick up lead. Evolution now picking up a penalty for Kansas City as Chicana Brusia is out for New Hampshire.
So pressure from New Hampshire inspiring Peter Babriel to call off the jam with only 3 points out of her scoring pass. It's 83-50. Thanks to Radar Wheels, here's a palindrome break brought to you by Radar Wheels. Do not bob, do nod. Radar palindrome.
Enigma now on the line for Kansas City up against, that is game overies for New Hampshire. New Hampshire in the black, Kansas City in the white. Enigma trying to through on the inside. Game overies looking at the outside line. Both skaters with good edge work. New Hampshire recycling Enigma. They're picking up a penalty for a clockwise block. Number 36, Boyer. Lead jammer, Enigma, Kansas City. But quickly out behind, about 10 feet behind, is Game Overies. Game Overies hits the pack. 2 points award to Kansas City. No points for New Hampshire.
Kansas City blockers doing a great job getting to the top of the pack there to make it harder for Game Overies to pick up any points on the jam.
You're looking at that beautiful new scoreboard on the WFTDA.tv screen. You can see the rectangles at the bottom indicating the timeouts used, the circle indicating that they still have, both squads still have an official timeout.
Number MI6, Persassin, jamming against number 79, Mary Lou Wretched for Kansas City. Kansas City in the white, and in the black, New Hampshire roller derby.
Mary Lou Wretched through, lead jammer, Kansas City.
Kansas City has managed to get all 4 lead calls this half so far.
Locking it down. Mary Lou Wretched is through, picking up the full 5 points for Kansas City. Assassin still stuck in the pack. Bella Fire and Evolution making hard work for her. Barbarian up front as well. And now she is through in her initial pass for New Hampshire. Rump record of the box for Kansas City, as well as number 1990 C in spots for New Hampshire.
Mary Lou Wretched with good pack awareness sees the opposing jammer approaching, calls it with 4 points. It's 89 on the board for Kansas City. Sorry, 94 on the board for Kansas City. And then 52 for New Hampshire roller derby as we hit the 26-minute mark in our second period of play.
It's all been Kansas City thus far for lead call. Swirko on the line for New Hampshire up against Jamalama Ding Dong for Kansas City. One blocker apiece in the box for both squads.
That penalty box brought to you by Notorious R.E.D. at NotoriousRED.com. Smell clean even if you play dirty.
New Hampshire with the wall up front. KC with the wall at the back. Recycling Jamalima Ding Dong from Kansas City to the back of turn one. And through lead jammer, New Hampshire, Swerko.
That, I believe, is the first scoreless jam of the game.
How about that?
Leaving the score at 94 for Kansas City and 52 for New Hampshire. Dr. Dredd back to the start line for Kansas City against 33-33, Chicana Brusia. 24 and a half to go in the game.
Both packs have all their skaters. Dr. Dredd looking at the outside. Chicana Brusia looking through the middle. Both jammers adept at pushing to the inside to prevent themselves from stepping out of bounds. And through lead jammer, Dr. Dredd, Kansas City. Chicana Brusia stuck behind the Stay Slaughter, Barbarian. And now picking up an out-of-play penalty, Barbarian, into the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box. And a back block call assessed to Dr. Dredd. Power jam, New Hampshire. We're going to go 2 minutes here as Dr. Dredd was your lead jammer.
And that's a minute and 20 seconds left for Chicana Brusia to try and undo the damage. New Hampshire have only received 2 points this entire period, but that's five more.
Now penalty assessed to a New Hampshire skater, number 828, Kissy Kicks. Chicana Brusia now working on that wall of three up at the front of the pack.
Kissy Kicks, a recent transfer to New Hampshire from Maine Roller Derby.
Chicana Brusia now with one to beat. Oh, recycling up front.
Good bridging by Kansas City, extending the reach of the pack.
Chicana Brusia now recycling herself behind Estee Slaughter. She did not step out of bounds. She could have gone in front of Estee Slaughter at that point. Dr. Dredd threw 4 points on that pass for Kansas City.
30 seconds remaining in this two-minute jam.
Kissy Kicks back on the track, reforming that wall at the rear for Dr. Dredd to hit. Chicana Brusia now still stuck in the pack. Barbarian Evolution up front.
Pack getting really stretched out between turns one and two.
Dr. Dredd threw 5 points, Kansas City, to the box number 26 for New Hampshire. Chicka Chicka Bam Bam. And that's 2 minutes there. New Hampshire picking up 5 points there. No points for Kansas City on that pass. Tough slog for both jammers in that particular jam.
9 points on the jam, taking Kansas City into triple digits with a score of 103. 10 points on the jam for New Hampshire takes them to 62 points with 22 to go in the game. Thanks to Rollerbones at rollerbones.com. They, Rollerbones and Bones Bearings, make for a winning combination.
Two in the box for New Hampshire's blocking pack. Four out there for Kansas City. Peter Gabriel jamming for Kansas City against Swerko for New Hampshire. Despite only having two skaters out there, New Hampshire still doing a great job of keeping Peter Gabriel in check. That only takes it so far. Peter Gabriel through lead jammer, Kansas City. Swerko recycled by Bruiser and taking a big hit up front by Tough Noogies. And heading to the box is Boyer, number 36 for New Hampshire. Just as the box clears and two more skaters come from New Hampshire onto the track. Peter Gabriel threw 5 points, Kansas City.
So the differential continues in penalty minutes as well. 23 trips to the box at this moment for New Hampshire, 13 for Kansas City.
And New Hampshire's box fills up once again as Chicka Chicka Bam Bam heads to the box for a back blocking penalty for New Hampshire.
That now will be a fifth box trip for Chicka Chicka Bam Bam. Two more and she will have fouled out. Boyer also standing with five penalties.
Peter Gabriel put up 5 points on the board for Kansas City.
That's more than halfway through the jam now. Control remains with Peter Gabriel.
Annie Mall picking up a multiplayer block penalty for Kansas City. Chicka Chicka Bam 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 back on the track. to block for New Hampshire. Peter Gabriel calls off the jam just in time, putting 4 points on the board for Kansas City. No points on that jam for New Hampshire. Kansas City now pouring it on. 117 to New Hampshire, 62. 20 minutes and 20 seconds left in this game.
Thanks to Adam Wheels. Train hard, play smart, skate Adam. Adam Wheels at AdamWheels.com. Remember that you can reach us at Twitter hashtag talk numeral 2 WFTDA.
The jam has started. Game Overies versus Enigma. Bridged all the way to the rear of turn 4 is Enigma. As Game Overies is through, lead jammer, New Hampshire. First lead jam call for New Hampshire in a couple of jams. Only the second of this period. Kissy kicks to the box for New Hampshire. Enigma out of the pack as well, now eligible to score. Game Overies calls the jam. Pick up the full 4 points there for New Hampshire. They got to get the rhythm back here, Brad. They have been in the box too often, and Kansas City has been taking advantage of that.
They found that rhythm in the second half of the first period of play, and we're really cranking it out there, but they've only scored 16 points in the entire half so far, as opposed to 37 for Kansas City. Kansas City putting number 913, Jamalama Ding Dong, back on the line against number MI6, Chris Assen.
4-3 pack favoring Kansas City. Chris Assen at the rear. Jamalama Ding Dong at the front, and now she's recycled to the back of the pack.
Tough Noogie's taking a penalty for the Kansas City pack. It's a track cut. Well, a track cut on the... It's Jamalama Ding Dong jamming for Kansas City. Has to sit down for 30 seconds in the notorious RED penalty box.
Chris Assen still not out of the pack for New Hampshire, but the pack is very small now for Kansas City. As she is through now, assessed lead jammer, New Hampshire. New Hampshire's bench telling her to call off the jam, putting in some fresh legs. That is Swerko, number 60, will jam all by her lonesome. Kansas City, 117, New Hampshire, 66, 18 minutes left in this game.
I think that's only the second time that no points have been scored in a jam this game.
So this is good news for New Hampshire, 4 on the track for them. Kansas City only has 3, hoping to take advantage of less than 30 seconds now that remain in Jamalama Ding Dong's penalty.
So Swerko in the power start for New Hampshire. Start line brought to you by Fast Girl Skates. 7 years dedicated to making a faster you. FastGirlSkates.com.
New Hampshire now bridging back, forcing Tough Noogies and Jamalama Ding Dong to come in right around the jammer line. Tough Noogies now with some offense. Freeze Jamalama Ding Dong to the inside, but nice work by New Hampshire reforming their wall right at turn one. Swerko putting points on the board, but still stuck behind a nice three wall of Kansas City skaters, anchored by Bruiser, number 24 for Kansas City. Tough Noogies back to the box for Kansas City.
Tough Noogies' second trip to the penalty box, so not anywhere close to penalty trouble yet.
Bruiser recycles Swerko to the back of turn one. Forced her to call off the jam. Picking up 4 points there on that pass for New Hampshire. 5 points there.
Those points taking New Hampshire to a total score of 71 on the board. Kansas City in triple digits with 117. Approaching the halfway mark of the period with 16 minutes to go. Mary Lou Wretched taking the star again against number 33, Chicana Brusia in the black of New Hampshire.
4-3 favoring New Hampshire's blocking pack. Good wall by both squads. But Mary Lou Wretched through lead jammer, Kansas City. Chicana Brusia with one to beat up front. That's Annie Mall.
Once again, the pack divides with the Kansas City blockers hanging on at the top of the pack. New Hampshire blockers at the back.
Pivot to the box for New Hampshire.
Rage of Aquarius, number 1967.
Jam called before either skater can put more points on the board, but positive point differential for Kansas City. 121, New Hampshire 71.
Nice round, 50-point lead, and we are seeing a timeout being called. It is an official review by New Hampshire, giving me time to thank Rydell Skates. Unmatched quality and unmatched performance, RydellSkates.com. We'll stay tuned, and our wonderful producer, Sweet Willie, will find out the substance of this official review as soon as we can. So, taking a look so far in the period, 21 points scored by New Hampshire, 41 points by Kansas City, 2-1 margin there. So, if this continues, it'll be a repeat of the last time these two teams met. So stay tuned to find out the substance of this review. Clock is stopped, 15 minutes and 21 seconds.
It may have just been a team timeout, apparently.
Ah.
Those brought to you by Roller Derby Athletics.
Roller Derby Athletics can change your game in 30 seconds, too. Find out more at rollerderbyathletics.com.
Enigma jamming for Kansas City up against number PM5. Game over is for New Hampshire. Kansas City in white, New Hampshire in the black. Picking up lead jammer, Enigma, Kansas City. Game over is up front, working on Bella Fire and Evolution. And she is through on the inside on her initial pass for New Hampshire. A stay slaughter to the box for Kansas City.
Enigma remains in control of the jam. Does not call it before Game Overies gets into the pack. 4 points on the pass for Kansas City, but another four for New Hampshire.
Kansas City now choosing to do a points for points swap here. And she calling off the jam. Emphatically picking up 3 points there, but 2 points assessed to New Hampshire on that last pass.
So it's a 1 point win on the jam for Kansas City. And now we have an official timeout, stopping the clock at 14 minutes and 19 seconds. 128 on the board for KC and 77 for NH. Are you enjoying the WFTDA Division I tournament? We hope you are. If you would like to pick up some commemorative WFTDA merchandise, you can do so at WFTDA.com/store.
Looks like we are now in an official review. The alternate for New Hampshire out there discussing it with the head ref, as well as bringing out the captains and alternate from both squads onto the track.
Coming up at, I believe it is 12 o'clock Pacific time. Yes, we've got Tampa Roller Derby playing Blue Ridge, and that will be the next exciting game. We're finding out the review here. Or not quite yet. Stand by. So I think we do have time to once again thank Adam Wheels, a proud partner of the WFTDA for 6 years running. Visit adamwheels.com.
So where we stand on penalties now, New Hampshire has the bulk of them. They have two
Absolutely.
Skaters with 5 penalties. They have 2 skaters with 4 penalties. Kansas City, they have 2 skaters with 3 sets of penalties.
Although the relative differential has calmed down a bit in New Hampshire's favor. They had been tracking 2-for-1 against Kansas City. At this very instant, we've got 26 box trips for New Hampshire, 18 for KC. Kansas City with the bulk of the lead calls in the second half.
And we'll take it to Willie for the assessment on that official review.
Another review on a penalty, or one that the team believed should have been called, a back block, but it was upheld. There was no back block penalty on the outside of the track, and we will continue.
Thank you, Willie. You will now see that little circle go clear at the bottom of New Hampshire's, saying that their official review, or it's gone. No more official review.
But if you've been paying attention to WFTDA rules, you will know that as of now, if you win your first official review, you get to keep it for a period. Chris Sasson to the penalty box. Power jam for Peter Babriel, lead jammer.
Four blockers on the track for both squads now. New Hampshire walling up at the front. KC opening up their wall to let their jammer through. Now playing some offense. Excellent recycling work there by number 21 Decker for New Hampshire. And sending, Kissy Kick sends Peter Babriel all the way to the back of turn one. Now New Hampshire is at the rear of the pack.
This is only the second penalty of the game for Prasasin, and both of them track cuts.
Prasasin back on the track for New Hampshire. She stayed in bounds the entire time, so she was did not have to come back out. Working on Estee Slaughter, and she is through for New Hampshire. Peter Babriel behind that wall of tough New Hampshire blockers calls off the jam, picking up the full 5 points there on that pass for KCR Dub.
Only 40 seconds remaining in that jam, so that was a pretty long one for 5 points. 133 on the board for Kansas City, still 77 for New Hampshire as we tick down to about 12 and a half to go in the game.
Thanks for tuning in to WFTDA.tv. New Hampshire in the black, Kansas City in the white. Dr. Dread the jam for Kansas City up against number 60, Swerko for New Hampshire.
Matchup we've seen several times before in this game.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Dr. Dread's number 47. Both skaters in the scrum. And throwing the inside, Swerko, lead jammer, New Hampshire. Number 21, Decker, working on Dr. Dread, but Dr. Dread is through now for Kansas City. Swerko hits that wall hard. Calls off the jam. 1 point there for New Hampshire. No points to Kansas City. That was a hard-fought 1 point.
And that was about a one-minute jam as we approach 11 and a half to go in the game. Mary Lou Wretched will be the next jammer for the Kansas City Roller Warriors in the white and in the black of New Hampshire Roller Derby, number 33-33, Chicana Brusia.
Four on four in the blocking pack, poised up against the Fast Girl Skate start line. Chicana Brusia working through the middle. Mary Lou Wretched also working the middle of the track. Such strong skaters. Able to hold that wall for both squads, preventing the jammers through.
Kansas City pushing up to the top of the pack where Rage of Aquarius is the last line of defense. Mary Lou through for her lead.
Chicana Brusia stuck. Looks like that's Annie Mall to the box for Kansas City. Chicana Brusia through, but she cut the track. She will be heading to the box for New Hampshire. Mary Lou Wretched picking up all the points. 5 points on that pass for Mary Lou Wretched.
By contrast, Mary Lou Wretched, zero trips to the notorious RED penalty box this game.
So far, clean sheet for the jammer from Kansas City. Big offense there by Tough Noogies and Bruiser. Freeze Mary Lou Wretched on the inside. 5 points for Kansas City.
Pack hovering in turn three.
Kansas City choosing a wise strategy of staying at the front, waiting for the pack to be pushed forward, and then converging on the blockers from New Hampshire. Matilda beat, and she is through. 5 points for Mary Lou Wretched.
McKilla Queen, number six for New Hampshire, to the penalty box. It was a multiplayer block.
Oh, Tough Noogies with a big hit at turn four. Forced Chicana Brusia to the ground and a recycle back behind turn four. Mary Lou Wretched with another 5 points on the board for Kansas City. Big run by Kansas City on this jam.
Yeah, 20 points so far.
Chicana Brusia now out for New Hampshire. Mary Lou Retchett continuing to skate. Four more points there. We went the full 2 minutes on that jam. Kansas City lighting it up. Kansas City 157, New Hampshire 78. Big old jam for Mary Lou Retchett.
Only 9 minutes to go in the game. Thank you to Printco Graphics for all your printing needs. Hit up printcographics.com. Your next set of jammers. Enigma number 10 has been jamming a few times now in this second period of play, taking on Game Over Ease number PM5 for New Hampshire.
The jam has started. Skaters briefly pause to assess and push forward. Enigma now up at the front. She's through. Lead jammer, Kansas City. Game Over Ease making a move. One to beat up front. That's Evolution. Formidable one to beat. And she is through, eligible to score for New Hampshire.
So that pressure is going to limit Kansas City to one scoring pass of 4 points.
Kansas City locking it down, really taking advantage of the penalties assessed to the New Hampshire blockers, taking advantage of those small packs, using some offensive smarts there and getting their jammers out and in control. Peter Babriel jamming for Kansas City up against Swirko for New Hampshire. One skater in the box for New Hampshire.
Last time these two jammed against each other, Peter Babriel earned lead, and that repeats itself. Three in a row for Kansas City.
Swirko pushing on that wall up at the front of the pack for New Hampshire. Peter Babriel stuck behind a wall at the rear and throwing the inside. Kansas City 5 points for Peter Babriel. There's a sledgehammer joke in there somewhere. Swirko through for New Hampshire. Just about a half lap behind, but Peter Babriel in control. Calls off the jam. Tough noogies with some good defense at the back of the pack, but she picks up 1 point for New Hampshire. 4 points on that pass for Kansas City.
Total of 9 on the jam. And the next thing up is number 7, Tampa. Number 7 seed in the tournament. Playing the number 10 seed in the tournament, Blue Ridge. That'll be at noon Pacific time.
The winner of this bout will go on to face Gotham Girls Roller Derby All-Stars at 4 p.m. Pacific time. The loser of this bout will play the loser of the Denver versus Santa Cruz tomorrow at 12 p.m. Pacific.
MI6 is Persassin with the Jammer Star for New Hampshire. Number 913 is Jamalama Ding Dong with the Jammer Star for Kansas City.
Big hit there by New Hampshire on Jamalama Ding Dong. Rump record to the box there for Kansas City. Picking up lead, it's Persassin for New Hampshire. They need to be in control here. Need to stay on the track, keep Jamalama Ding Dong contained, and maybe they can pull a cut track penalty on her. Good recycling there by New Hampshire, but their pack got spread out, and Jamalama Ding Dong now through for Kansas City.
Persassin watching Jamalama Ding Dong approach, calls it off. Three total on the jam for New Hampshire. It's 82 to 170. Yeehaw! Brooklyn skates! Designed in New York, made in Tennessee. BrooklynSkateCo.com.
All those things right there. All of that. I love it.
Dr. Dredd, number 47 for Kansas City. Jamming against number PM5, whom we've seen on the jammer line a lot today. That's Game Overuse for New Hampshire as we approach the 5-minute mark in the game.
4-on-4 in the pack. Kansas City walling up. They are in white. New Hampshire in the front in black. Dr. Dredd now stuck behind all the walls. And picking up a penalty is Annie Maul. She'll head to the box for Kansas City. Dr. Dredd through, lead jammer, Kansas City.
Annie Maul in potential penalty trouble here. Can't afford too many more trips to that notorious RED penalty box.
Back block penalty now on Dr. Dredd. Power jam, New Hampshire. We're going to go the full 2 minutes here as Dr. Dredd was your lead jammer. Game over, he's through. Can now put points on the board for New Hampshire. 4-3 pack favoring New Hampshire as well.
A minute to go in the jam.
And number 21, picking up a pack destruction penalty is Decker. Packett started to move forward, and she visibly slowed down, allowing the pack to be split up. And tough noogies up at the front with amazing defense on game ovaries, recycling her all the way to the back of turn four.
That was Dicker's fifth trip to the box. She's got to be careful, too.
There are three skaters now with five trips to the box on the New Hampshire side. Dr. Dredd back in the mix for Kansas City, hitting that three wall of New Hampshire skaters. And Noogies with a little bit of offense on the inside line. Dr. Dredd freed, 5 points on the board for the Roller Warriors. 5 points on the board there for game ovaries.
Very close to the end of the game. Clock completely on Kansas City's side. They would be very happy to just trade points for the rest of the game. A back block call on Dr. Dredd is going to give an opportunity, though, for New Hampshire to close the gap a bit. 3 points on the pass there for New Hampshire. Total of 8 on the jam. Total of 90 on the board. 175 for Kansas City as we tick past the 3 minute mark of the game.
All right, so power jam, because Dr. Good just sat down in the penalty box for Kansas City. Power jam first, Swerko.
Thanks to Rydell Skates, defining the concept of fit for over 65 years, rydellskates.com.
New Hampshire now awaiting at the rear of the pack. Swerko knocked down hard right outside the pivot line. Pack is assessed at the rear. Rump record there goaded by the New Hampshire wall.
Pack slow and tight in turn two.
Excellent defense there by that Kansas City wall. Bella Fire, Barbarian. And out of play penalty assessed to Barbarian. She will head to the notorious RED penalty box and ask, what is best in life? Swerko through on the inside. And that's the jam. 4 points to New Hampshire, 3 points to Kansas City. Kansas City take their score to 178, New Hampshire 94. Less than 2 minutes in this game. First game of D1, almost over. Kansas City in a commanding lead, the 178, New Hampshire 94.
Good chance this will be the last jam of the game with number 79, Mary Lou Wretched, taking the star for Kansas City against Chicana Brusia, number 33-33 for New Hampshire.
Mary Lou Wretched up front, picks up lead jammer at the front of the pack. Chicana Brusia behind Bruise Her and Annie Mall. And Chicana Brusia now out, just about 10 feet behind. Looks like we had a skate malfunction of some kind. And Mary Lou Wretched calls off the jam, so we will have one more jam as we have 50 seconds left. Maybe axle destruction happened there.
So score remains at 178-94. Advantage Kansas City. Remember to join us at noon Pacific time for number 7 Tampa versus number 10 Blue Ridge. Those number 7, number 10 being the seeds in this tournament. Number MI6 Prisassin with the star for New Hampshire against number 0, Peter Babriel.
Peter Babriel recycled there behind number 36, Boyer for New Hampshire. And Bruiser recycling Prisassin all the way to the back of turn 4. And more recycling by Boyer. Environmentally conscious, apparently, for New Hampshire. Peter Babriel to the back. And more recycling by Evolution. On Prisassin, barely past the second turn, and through lead jammer, Peter Babriel. She can see victory in her eyes, and she calls off the jam as the period clock ends. That will be the end of the game. Unofficial score right now, Kansas City 178, New Hampshire 94. Resounding victory by the Roller Warriors from Kansas City, Missouri.
So Kansas City really owned that second period of play. At halftime, it was a much closer game, only 77-49, and that first period included a really solid run by New Hampshire closing the gap. But if you look at just the points scored in the second period of play, that is 98 points for Kansas City and only 44 points for New Hampshire.
And the winner of this bout, that's Kansas City. They go on to face the All-Stars from Gotham at 4 p.m. Pacific time. New Hampshire will face the loser of the Denver versus Santa Cruz, which comes up at 2 p.m. today. And so they will play the loser of that game at 12 p.m. Pacific time tomorrow.
Remember that you can reach us at Twitter, hashtag talk, numeral 2, WFTDA, and our compatriot, Captain Lou Elbamo, points out that Peter Babriel is proving once again that jammers in glasses do indeed get their passes.
Captain Lou, thank you for the wisdom. We appreciate it. New Hampshire now taking their lap. Hard fought, so what Kansas City has to do this afternoon to beat Gotham? Discussion on that one, Brad?
To beat Gotham, they've got a... They've got a tough row to hoe, I have to say. Gotham, the three-time defending champions of the Women's Flat Track Derby Association, have not been beaten in sanctioned play in that time. So the only thing you can do against Gotham is go to basics. You know,
that's right.
Try and contain Gotham's jammers with the renowned Bonnie Thunders and Susie Hot Rod chief among them, but it's not like they have a shallow jammer rotation either.
This is true.
And then if you can find a hole, if blockers like Sexy Slady are able to give you, choose to give you one or what have you, take them. That's all you can do against Gotham.
I think between now and 4 p.m., maybe some ice, maybe maybe a little bit of strategy discussion, but a hard-fought bout by New Hampshire, proving that they do belong here at this playoff and taking it to KC when they could, when they stayed out of the penalty box.
New Hampshire's only second appearance in the playoffs, but Kansas City, a perennial visitor to the WFTDA playoffs, will see them again today.
All right, stay tuned. We've got number 7, Tampa, versus number 10, Blue Ridge, 12 p.m. Pacific time.
Just about half an hour.
This is excellent. Welcome to Day 1, D1, Sacramento, California, the beautiful Memorial Auditorium. Thank you for hosting Sacred City Derby Girls.
For WFTDA.TV. I've been Brad Example.
And I've been Joe Mama.
I can't even say my own name.
Hey, I'm Raucous Ron, here for WFTDA.TV. I'm here with Annie Mall, one of the heroes of our game here. Pretty fun game, eh?
Oh my gosh, it was so much fun. We love playing New Hampshire. They're really strong. They work together. They're great sportswomen. So it was a great game, and it was also nice that we won.
Yeah. Absolutely fantastic, and this is particularly special for you because I know that you're retiring after many, many years of roller derby. How does that feel?
It's bittersweet. I can't lie that I'm ready to take some time off, but I love everyone, and it's hard to say goodbye, but I'll still be around. I'll still come to tournaments and hang out and stuff, so.
Awesome. It's been wonderful to watch you all these years, but now that you've won this game, you've got to go up against Gotham at 4 o'clock. So, you know, what do you think coming into that game? What's your strategy? What are you thinking?
I think we're just going to do like we do with every tough team we come up against. We're going to play the best we can, give it our best effort, and hopefully smile through it.
Absolutely, and that's one of the things I love about Kansas City. Great, positive attitude, lots of smiles on the track, win or lose. So thank you, Annie Mall, and for WFTDA.TV.
I smell something awful. We've been meaning to talk to you about that.
What? Notorious Gear Deodorant. It's not us, it's you.
Please tell me that was you.
What? Notorious Gear Deodorant. Smell the magic.
You're watching WFTDA.TV.